These two rules here form what is known more formally as the Collatz series, named after the German mathematician Lothar Collatz. And it behaves somewhat erratic, as I think you've seen with a program. Sometimes it will terminate very quickly for certain values of I, and sometimes actually it will behave super erratic, and it will go up and down and up and down until it finally terminates. Now here's the thing. It has been conjectured that this algorithm here will terminate for any value of I. But so far, nobody has been able to prove that. So if we were given an integer for this function here, for which the Collatz hypothesis that this algorithm here always terminates has not been verified, then that would indeed be undecidable. Now, truth be told, it would have to be a very large integer because the Collatz hypothesis has been verified for large numbers indeed. Nevertheless, once the integer is out of this range, we have no way of deciding whether this algorithm will terminate or not. The only thing we can do is run it. So the Collatz problem, or Collatz hypothesis, is an open mathematical problem. And of course, as you know, it's not the only open mathematical problem, so we could have other mathematical problems as well. But I want to show you something. So if we had an algorithm that solves the halting problem, so if we indeed had this algorithm halt, what we could then do, for example, is write the following program for I equals 1 to, say, 10 to the power of 100, then run the Collatz rules for I. So we start with I equals 1, then we go to I equals 2, and so on. And then we feed this problem into the halting algorithm. And now if the halting algorithm says yes, then this means that the Collatz hypothesis is true for any number from 1 to 10 to the power of 100. And if it says no, then it means that there is some number for which the Collatz hypothesis is not true, which means that this part here would go into an infinite loop. And then we can easily check this for larger and larger and larger numbers. An algorithm that would be able to solve the halting problem would actually be able to solve almost any open mathematical problem there is out there. Any mathematical problem that can be formulated as an algorithm could be decided by an algorithm that solves the halting problem. So this would almost be a kind of omniscient algorithm, which also provides an intuition why this halting algorithm here cannot possibly exist. It would just simply be too powerful. It could answer almost any mathematical question that we can think of.